Oh, it's on me. I don't know why it flips automatically to me when you start that.
Okay, hi everybody, welcome to Penalty Box. My name is Jennifer Long, I'll be your instructor today. Penalty Box is an agility workout that we're going to do today. It's made up of moves that you typically would do if we were in a live class with this box. But obviously today, we're doing a virtual class, so just pretend like you have a box, okay? You'll need it when we do an actual live class, which I'm hoping you'll come to in North Liberty. We would love to have you there, and I'll provide boxes for everybody if you come. So penalty box is made up of four rounds. There's two moves per round, and each move is 1 minute. So we're going to do a total of 16 minutes of actual movement with some breaks in between, and then we'll have a couple of recovery exercises after the first round. Then we'll just repeat the same thing again. So you'll be out of here 20, 25 minutes. Okay, great. So we're going to start with a warm-up. The warm-up is going to consist of 5 roll downs to begin with. So we're just going to roll down to our feet slow and roll back up. And don't worry if you can't touch your feet. It's okay. Some of us can and some of us can't. So no worries there. Okay, a couple more. And we're going to switch to some hip circles. We use your legs a lot in penalty box, so we want to get your hips loosened up well enough. Okay. So hip circles are just out. Five on each side. And again, it just loosens up the hip joint and your glutes, but also your hip flexors here in the front of your legs. Because doing agility, it's a lot of movement with your hips and your hip flexors. So two more on each side. And then we're going to move to some side bends. We're going to loosen up your low back and your obliques. Because we're going to be in plank for part of this as well. So side bends. Just going to go down on each side. Yeah, this is just nice and slow. Your hands should not go past your knee. We're just trying to loosen things up. Okay. Two more. Good. And now we're going to loosen up your shoulders. So we're going to put one hand here, and we're just going to rotate your arm around 5 times on each side. Again, these are for those planks, right? Get your shoulders loosened up. Go ahead and switch. Okay, so for those of you that have Apple Watches that are doing this workout, you can set it to high interval or high intensity interval training, and it'll track the workout in that way, because we are going to have bursts of work and then a rest, and then bursts of work and then rest, okay? All right, so we're going to start with forward and back. So basically, forward and back just looks like this. Now, you can go at whatever pace you want, okay? You can step, or you can run, doesn't matter, okay? At some point during the minute, I'm going to say turn, and I'm going to ask you to just switch. It can be right or left, doesn't matter, okay? All right, so 1 minute forward and back. Here we go. And again, you do want to get your heart rate up, right? That's the whole point of doing agility training. Your heart rate's up, then it comes down, bring it up, and you bring it back down. So, keep going. You can lead with whichever foot you want to. Doesn't matter, but when you turn, I'm going to ask you to switch the foot you're leading with. So, turn. So as you can see now, I'm leading with my left foot instead of my right. Part of penalty box is just training your brain, right? You got to keep you thinking clearly, moving clearly, getting your heart rate up. And as we get more tired and our heart rate gets higher, it's a little harder to think. So don't worry about that. Just work on it. I'm going to turn again. Again, I'm leading with my right foot now. About 10 more seconds. We're done with this round. 3, 2, and good. Okay, so I have a timer over here on the right. My husband is graciously running the timer for me, so I don't have to pay attention to all of that. So, okay, next move. I'm going to have a seat on the floor. Again, when you have the box, you'll use it like this, but otherwise you're just going to lift your feet. So we're just going to go over, 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 for 1 minute, okay? If both feet at the same time is too much, we're just gonna go 1, 1, 1, 1. You can do whatever works for you, okay? Ready? Begin. And soon into it, you'll know that this is a core group, right? I'm trying to work. middle of your core and your obliques. Your obliques are the muscles that run down the sides of your abs. And it's really important to work those as well. Okay? Just do this for a little bit. If you need a break, just stop for a second. And then jump back in when you're ready. Okay? We are halfway done already. Keep going. You're doing great. Down the modification. Step, 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 step. And eventually you can progress to both plates at the same time. And some people can do it with their hands up like this. Good. You got about 10 seconds left. Keep going. We're going to stand up here. Do some jumps after this. So we'll give your abs a little bit of a break. 3, 2, and 1. Whoops. Sometimes that happens too. Okay, so locks back out flat. Come on up. We're going to switch to some side jumps now. Okay, so side jumps. Start out to the side. And you're going to jump, jump, jump. Jump, jump, jump. Now, modification. Step, step. Step, step. Okay? Just for 1 minute, side to side. Ready? Begin. So as you can imagine, this is definitely going to get your heart rate up over an entire minute. And you're kind of settling a little bit once you get to the side. A little break. 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 Step, 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 step. Good. Jump, jump, jump. Good. You're doing great. We're more than halfway done. Keep going. Your arms can move the way mine are, or you can do one at a time. Whatever feels most comfortable for you. And 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Okay. We're going to take a quick drink break. So, very important to stay hydrated, particularly when you're doing agility training because you're going to sweat a lot. Okay. Next move is a circle run. So, bring the box back up. You can put a towel in the middle of the floor, an extra shoe, your child, whatever. Just gonna run around, okay? At 30 seconds, we'll switch and go the other way. Returning the nut rings, okay? Ready? Begin. And as you can see, this does not have to be a super fast run. We just wanna keep your heart rate. Get it up there and keep it up as best we can. So keep going. If running is too much, just step it out, right? We're still going in that circle, still getting our heart rate up, still keeping those big muscles in your legs moving, which is really, really important. And switch. Now we're going to go the other way. Train our brains, mix it up a little bit. Just keep going. Keep going. If it's too much, just sort of guess where the thing is you're running around. You can definitely just do it this way, right? If that gets to be too much, just be facing it. That's great. So we have about 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice job. Okay, next is shoulder walks. So we're gonna be down on the floor. This is the plank exercise that I was talking about before. So we're gonna start up in plank, and just forward, forward, back, back. Forward, forward, back, back. Now, if that's too much, totally get that. Sometimes stand in that plank for a whole minute, harden your shoulders, wrists, whatever. So, modification. Be on your knees, and back and forth, okay? But make sure, when you're doing this, I'm gonna turn to the side so you can see my body. If you're on your knees, I don't want you up here like this. That's not doing anything, okay? I want you flat, forward, forward, back, back. Because that is what's going to work your abs and those obliques down the side. Okay? 1 minute, shoulder walks. Ready? Go. I'm not going to be able to look at you a lot during this one because in order to keep my neck in alignment, I need to look it's in front of the box. So just keep going, do the best you can. This one can be tough. Try to keep your abs tight, your glutes down. We don't want to have a walk like this, right? You want to be down flat. Good, keep going. Where are we at? We're more than halfway done. Keep it up. You can do it. I'm going to stand up after this, I promise. Your arms if you can. Again, this is how we train our brain. Switch something up right in the middle. Keep going. Let's turn. Keep going. Keep moving fast. Good. Not only are you getting your heart rate up, you're getting lots of steps during this minute for sure. So your Fitbit's going to love you. All right, we are more than halfway up. Keep going. When you have a box, we'll do things like move to the front boxes, move to the back boxes. We're going to turn it in, right? So you're just going to go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice job. Okay, hurdle jumps are next. So, again, when you have the box, you'll hurdle it up like this. We're just going to jump and jump, okay? If that's too much, you can step. Now, the thing I want you to keep in mind is, I don't want this jump. That doesn't do anything for your abs, okay? Leg up and jump, and leg up and jump, okay? 1 minute, ready, go. Just a small tap with your foot that's coming second over the hurdle. So you're not stopping completely and then jumping, it's just a small tap, and you keep going. Remember, knees in front, so you can keep your abs engaged. And you can hear how winded I'm getting. This is still a workout for me too, for sure. Carrying on with modification. Step. Okay, and jump. We are more than halfway done. So keep going, you can do it. Take a modification if you need to. But keep pushing yourself. It's only 1 minute. Now it's only 10 seconds. So you got this. Keep it up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice job. All right, guys, last move of this first round. That's how fast it goes, okay? All right, we're gonna be here. We're gonna do in and out. So out, in, out, in. Now. Just pick a width that seems good for you, right? This box seems good for me. I have long legs. If you have shorter legs, just a little narrower, okay? Again, we're just trying to get your heart rate up, keep your body moving, okay? 30 seconds, we're gonna switch our lead leg. Turn your brain. Let's go. Out, in, out. Yeah, modification, right? Either one, whichever one you feel like works better for you. You can do part of one, part of the other. But again, this is only 20, 25 minutes. You gotta push yourself, right? Do what's best for your body. All right, in 3 seconds, we're gonna switch our lead leg, 2, and 1. So now I'm leading with my left leg. And yeah, it feels weird, right? I'm very, very right-handed. But I just have to think about it a little bit more. And I think that keeps it a little more interesting too, right? I'm not just doing the same thing for a minute, just kind of hanging up there. So, the last 10 seconds, I'm going to ask you to speed it up. Now, go, 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 whoops, go, go. 3, 2, and 1. Good. Tripped on my box a little bit there, that happens. All right, round one is done. Nice job. So, quick drink break, and then we're going to repeat, and then we're done. So a windmill, arms out, can you stop the timer for a minute? Thanks. And we're just gonna reach to the opposite toe and back up, and this is slow, right? And begin. So 30 seconds of just this active movement. That brings our heart rate down a little bit, right? But it doesn't stop, and we don't just stop. We don't go from in and out for a full minute, full blast, to just stopping. That is not good for our bodies. We need to cool it down slowly. So here we go. We're just reaching for that opposite toe, stretching our low back and our obliques. Bring up 3, 2, and 1. All right, nice job, guys. So now we just repeat, and then we'll stretch a little bit, and we're done. Okay? You're doing great. So we're going back to the forward and back. All right. So forward, back, like this. And again, at some points we'll turn, we'll switch which foot we're leading with. All of that, okay? Forward and back. Let's go. And as quickly as you can, get that heart rate up, get those steps. Like me, you look at those steps right before you go to bed, and you're super close. You're like, man, I could just run a little bit faster. And then I get up and walk around the house, right? So, okay, turn. Switch the foot that I'm leading with. And again, remember the mod. Step, 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 okay? Just get your heart rate up. Turn back forward, switching my lead leg, my right foot now, which feels so much more comfortable to me. You're doing great. Keep going. We're way more than halfway done. You can do this. Switch again. Turn and switch your lead foot. Front, front, back, back. Try to keep your abs in tight so you can support your low back. In 3, 2, good. Okay, hurdle leg lifts. So, hurdle up. I'm excited for you guys to come to a leg class because it's fun when everybody has a box and we can all work on this together. So, remember, we're going up and over or step, 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 step. Okay? And begin. Another thing you might notice partway through this is your hip flexors. You start to feel it there. Those are the muscles kind of right where your legs bend in the front. So as your abs get stronger and you do more penalty box, you won't feel it there as much because your abs will be doing more of the work. So just trust the process, stay with the program, do what you need to do, okay? We are almost halfway done. Another modification. Step, 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 step. Good. Upper side jumps coming up next. So we're gonna stand up after this. Shake our legs out a little bit, get a drink, and then do some side jumps. So we have 10 seconds. You've got this. Anything for 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2. You're done. Good. Alright, box is black. Standing up, let's get a quick drink. Stay hydrated. Woo! Go back to those side jumps and show you a second. So, we're starting starting on the outside of the box. Jump, wait. Okay, otherwise step. Okay, so either one, again, you can mix them up if you want to. Try to jump as much as you can, okay? And begin. So as you can hear, I'm breathing heavy, right? This is getting my heart rate up for sure. Keeps me moving. And I write these workouts to be easy for me. Definitely more of a challenge as well. But if you have suggestions or something we can do with the box, please let me know. Send me a message on this video. You can find me at LT Fitness on Instagram or Long Term Fitness on Facebook. Send me a quick message because I am happy to change it up. All right, 20 seconds. Narrow feet like this, right? But you can also have wide feet. If that feels easier, then you feel like you're going to rock less, right? Because a lot of times when you do a plank move like this, your hips rock. So if you want that to happen less, just put your feet out wider. Give yourself a wider base of support. So keep going. Just going to check for more than halfway done. You guys, we got this. I know it's burning. I know your abs are probably on fire. That's the point, right? That's why you're here. Keep it up. Look. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job, guys. Good job. All right, pepper steps. So, if I'm being honest, this is my favorite move. So I feel like pepper steps, not only get your heart rate up, but you can really go quick because you don't have to think about lots of movement, okay? So remember, we're here, right? If you need to slow it down, it's more of a march. Get those arms moving so that heart rate goes sky high, okay? Are you ready? Go. Arms can be alternating, forward and back. But the floor is hot, right? And just go. As you can see, again, I'm equally as winded, right? This is pushing me. And I'm taking up some breaks. showing you the modifications in the house, so don't be hard on yourself. Do what you can do. We'll be here next week to try it again. Definitely. No problem there, so just keep going. We are again, I'm more than halfway done. You're doing great. Remember, arms are like this. You're running. Whatever feels most comfortable to you. Just keep those feet going. Quick. In 10 seconds. And we'll be done with this part. We just have 2 moves left after this, guys. 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Okay. Quick drink break. Hurdle jumps are next. All right. Again, hurdle jumps feel like a leg exercise. And they are. They're also for your abs. And that's why we bring our knee up in front, not back like this. This doesn't do anything for your abs. Grip your hamstrings. That's not what we're here to do. So, up and over, okay? Modification. Step, just like that, okay? 1 minute hurdle jumps, let's go. Remember, it's just that tap. That second foot there comes over. It's just that tap. You don't have to jump high. Just gotta clear whatever hurdle you put in front of yourself. And that's true about your life too, right? You just gotta clear that hurdle. Just give it all you got. We're at the end. We're tired, right? But we're still moving, we're still doing it. So keep going. Knees up in front. If you need to do the modification, stop for a minute, sort of reset, then jump again. Okay? And we're not going super fast, but we are. This is a plyometric move. We're getting both feet off the ground at the same time. We have 15 seconds. And then we're done with this move for a whole week. So keep going. You got it. Looking forward to just in and outs after this. 3, 2, and 1. Good. Okay, guys, one more move, and then we're done. We'll stretch it out. Rotation. Okay. So last move is in and outs, like I said. So out, in, right? Lead with your, I won't say your right leg, I'll say your dominant leg to start, okay? But we want to be jumping like this. As quickly as we can. For 30 seconds, we'll switch to our non-dominant leg. Go. Arms can kind of do whatever you want. Some people want to move them. I kind of prefer to keep them just right here, kind of my guard up a little bit, just so I can really think about what I'm doing with my feet. Right? Some moves in agility, it's nice to give your brain a little bit of a break, but most of the agility moves require some thinking. And we want that, right? We want our brains to be at the class, we want to be focused on what we're doing, get the most out of it. So, switch. Here I am, leading with my left leg. Like I said before, it feels kind of weird, but I'm doing it, right? I'm probably slower than I am on my right leg, and that's okay, because my brain's working harder. So, we're just trying to balance that body-brain connection, make it happen. Okay, 10 seconds, and we are done with this workout. You have been amazing. You've worked so hard. So, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Awesome, you guys. Good job. Okay. We do a little bit of stretching, and then you are on your way. So, big deep breath. We all could use a little more oxygen right now, right? Okay, let's stretch our shoulders, those shoulder taps. Shoulder walks that we did, rather. Those are tough. It's a long time to be up on a plank, on your knees or on your toes. It's a long time. We're going to switch. We need to be respectful of our bodies. Stretch them out, keep them mobile for the next time, right? If you work out and just stop, you don't stretch, your muscles are going to get tight and you're not going to be able to do this as well the next time. All right, let's try a few of those shoulder circles. 3, 4, and 5. Let's try the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And some quick torso rotations. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Guys, thank you so much for coming. This was so fun. I hope you have a great rest of your day. Happy Memorial Day. And we'll see you next Sunday. Bye.
Finish or stop?